Hello, and welcome to Ken Games. I promised you this. I'm going to continue with Call of Juarez.
I'd been on their trail for months, ever since they left their hideout in the Bighorn Mountains.
Now,
led by Butch Cassidy, they were a loose association of outlaws who robbed banks and trains from Colorado to Montana. Among them was the Sundance Kid, and that murderous hombre I was tracking, Roscoe Bob Bryant.
Were you a part of that giant Pinkerton posse after the Wild Bunch?
No, boy. A circus like that would have slowed me down. Besides, I wanted Bryant all to myself. I'd heard about a large shipment of gold being transported to Wilcox, Wyoming on the Overland Flyer. I figured the Wild Bunch would likely hit such a treasure, and by God, I figured right.
Yep.
They blew the bridge with the intention of forcing the train to stop. Well, I assumed the Wild Bunch was likely in the still intact part of the train high above. I was determined to make that sumbitch Bob pay for what he did to my brothers. I found the device they used to blow the tracks, so I knew I was headed in the right direction.
Mm-hmm. Well,
my ears are still ringing from blowing up that bridge.
Yep.
What'd you say?
Well, I made my way off unscathed and came upon a few members of the gang and had no choice but to dispatch them. From there, I had to negotiate an even more precarious route.
Ah, well, I changed mouse right now, so that's why I
But first, I would need to get my ass out of there.
Yep. But I'm used to using another mouse here. I only use the other mouse when special games. Only Mackerel. Okay. Whoa!
I jumped from the frying pan into the fire as the train was clearly fixing to fall. I had found the gang, but in order to find old Bob, I needed to fight my way forward past a whole passel of desperados. Yeah. Outside, inside, any way I could, I made my way towards my prey. Inside.
Well, what about the passengers?
It was mostly a freight train, as I recall. There were no passengers aboard that day.
Inside and outside, through his house. Wow.
As I mentioned before, I am not fond of heights.
Nope.
But I was too busy dodging bullets to worry about falling to my death. Odds were I was likely to die that day anyway. So I was determined to take down as many of those bastards as I could.
Whoa! Woo!
You ain't seen the likes of me.
You ain't seen the likes of me either, man.
At times it was like shooting ducks in a shooting gallery. The only difference is these damn ducks shot back.
Inside and outside. Oh well. Alright. Climb this.
I kept hoping the law would show up and give me a hand.
You mean like that giant Pinkerton posse that I read about?
No.
Did they come riding in, guns ablazing to help?
Help? From the Pinkertons? No, son. I had to fight the Wild Bunch all by my lonesome, as usual.
They disappeared.
Who the hell is that?
He's out of his mind!
Out of my mind? I doubt
that. Take cover! Retreat! Retreat!
He's killing everybody!
Now you're dead.
That was no good. No good at all. I should have changed weapon there. Blew his house. What a blue little window. Well, that or we could always, change your goddamn weapon.
My guess is those dime novels didn't portray this as it happened, did they?
Enter.
Only a few stragglers were left. I had to cut them down pronto if I was gonna stay on old Bob's trail. Once I silenced all those guns, I went searching for my nemesis.
Of course.
Determined to finally have my justice. But the only survivor who welcomed me was George Flatnose Curry.
Who was he?
The fastest gun in the gang. Right after Sundance, I mean.
Well?
And Kid Curry. And maybe Elsie Lay. Though some folks might dispute that. On that very same day, Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid decided to leave the Wild Bunch behind and decamped for South America.
Ooh, yeah.
An honorable kill again.
They ended up living down there for many years, but I'm sure you already know all about that.
Yep. Well, you know. Bob Bryant. So,
I tried to find Bob Bryant, but it was as if he'd disappeared. Sometime later, I heard the Wild Bunch was back together. Kid Curry escaped from jail, and now he was running the whole shebang. So I took to their trail, as I was still in pursuit of my brother's killer and hoped that he was back with them.
That Kid Curry's kind of crazy, ain't he?
Don't let him hear you saying that.
Anyways, I tracked those boys to a camp right outside Parachute, Colorado.
We're under fire!
Being outnumbered, I didn't bother with a warning shot. I just started taking those bastards down.
Cut it down!
Well, I prefer it to be me then, but hey ho. My god, how
old
bad
Bob
am I?
Old Bob wasn't among them, and neither was Kid Curry. I could sense them close by, however, plotting something nasty. I just needed a clue as to their whereabouts.
Yep. Well, I need a clue.
And I found one. A map with their bold plan clearly marked. This time they were fixing to blow up a train trestle. Uh-huh. Property of the Union Pacific.
Uh-huh. So I'm gonna go there, and I'm gonna have to stop them.
The plan clearly indicated how they were fixing to undermine several of the weakest wooden supports.
Dynamite! TNT. Yeah, dynamite. TNT. Oh, well.
Kid Curry was considered the wildest of the wild bunch.
That may have been a wrong way.
Kid Curry was considered the wildest of the wild bunch. It was said that he fathered 85 bastard children.
85?
Though some say it was only five.
Well. Whoa!
Kid Curry had bragged to a whore how he was gonna rob a train heading to the U.S. Mint in Denver. And that whore, Fat Sally, she told me.
Well, you know, a whore is a whore. It's a whore! Anyway, I don't like this place, by the way. It's never been my favorite.
The bridge was rigged with dynamite, so I decided I'd best be careful confronting those bastards.
Disarm.
A moment later, I saw a ladder that somehow had escaped my attention.
A ladder? Where'd that come from?
Don't worry, I know what I'm
doing. I didn't see that. Did you see that?
But the wild bunch did not take kindly to my presence and attempted to blow my head off. It appeared the kid had found a number of new recruits to bolster their ranks. Guess there's always desperate men willing to trade their lives for stolen treasure.
What happened next?
Well, having removed the first bundle of dynamite, I decided I might as well remove the other one. Once that was done, I figured I'd find my way from there.
A boom. Well, that's how we shoot.
So, what happened then?
Had to remove more of that damn dynamite. Mm-hmm.
Done.
It must have been terrifying trying to make your way across.
I was sweating it a bit, but then I noticed a footbridge tied up on high, so I shot the rope. Funny you should mention that, darling. As actually, there was a fourth charge impeding my progress.
Are you some kind of maniac?
Well. Booyah!
Once I removed it, my path was pretty clear.
Yeah.
Ooh.
You. Headshot. This guy's annoying or what?
Oh.
I'm not yellow. I'm, well, my guns are yellow, but, you know.
Time to die!
Where?
So I proceeded onward. I realized that that way just wasn't gonna work. I needed an alternate path forward.
And an alternate path, alright, well. Got it.
Luckily, I found a cave, and as I made my way back to the bridge, I saw something that concerned me.
Yep.
It was a long burning fuse.
Whoa.
And it was moving fast as hell. I had to catch it.
Mm-hmm.
Run!
The burning fuse was so damn quick, I had to run like the wind. I almost had it, but no! Thought I was gonna have a coronary when I lost sight of those sparks. My heart was pounding like a sledgehammer.
How? I don't know where, what, where, haha. Okay, I'm gonna have to try this again.
Get off the bridge!
Ah. What? How can I? Can't do that faster. Can I?
Get off the bridge!
I knew that failure meant boom! Then, finally, at the last moment.
Woo!
Of course, I was successful, or clearly I wouldn't be talking to you folks here today. Naturally, I removed the last dynamite charge.
Yeah.
Well, it was a touching reunion.
Well, better switch to those guns here.
But by this time, I was thoroughly exhausted and dragging my ass, as I was not a young man anymore.
Whoop.
Kill that Izuki! Make him bleed!
Send him to our dish!
Finally, I found those boys. Or more precisely, they found me. Just when I thought things couldn't get worse, Kid Curry opened up on me with a goddamn Gatling gun. It was hidden in this tunnel and pretty well shielded.
Ah! Gatling gun? Kid Curry? What the hell? Come on! Mm-hmm.
Kill him already!
Reload.
No.
Luckily, I had located some dynamite. Mm-hmm. I still, however, had my work cut out for me.
Am I out of bullets already?
Boom! Get closer to that point, but yeah.
Show yourself, you coward!
Over.
This is the last mistake you'll ever make.
Okay.
Oh. Yeah.
Yeah, that's great. But hey,
shit!
Gonna scalp your ass.
Beat that bastard.
You're gonna bleed.
Give me a hand here, goddammit!
I'll cut you, boy.
You can't hide from
that dynamite.
Eventually, I brought that tunnel down. And that's when I met Kid Curry himself. He had decided to stop pussyfooting around and deal with me personally. As he was, I was just a bit faster. And as he lay wounded, I demanded to know the whereabouts of Roscoe Bob Bryant. He shouted at me. Is that what this is about?
Bob
went with Butch and Sundance to South America. You ain't never finding him.
Whoa.
Those were his last words.
Yep. At least to me. He may have said something else to somebody else, but, you know, to me it was his last words. Even though I killed him. Yeah.
Bob Bryant got away? I knew I'd never find him in South America.
What about the other killer?
Yeah, you kind of glossed over that one.
Well, I found Jim not long after my showdown with Ringo. At the time, he was riding with the James Younger gang. Did I neglect to mention that?
Yeah. Jesse James.
Jesse James? Yeah. The greatest outlaw who ever lived?
Jesse and his kin rode with Quantrill when he raided Lawrence, Kansas and killed near 200 people, boy.
Yeah, nothing great about that.
And from there, him and his brother went on to rob banks and trains from Kansas to Missouri.
Which is why there was such a rich bounty on their heads. 40 grand for both of them, dead or alive. That's one hell of a payday.
Yep. Death rides a steel stallion. Well,
I confronted them as they were robbing a train. Bullets were flying at me from every which way. But I knew I'd have to fight my way forward if I was gonna find this gem.
Now, how'd they stop this train in the first place?
Well, the James boys were experts at this.
Hey. He could stop a train by staring it down.
They hopped a freight train, having heard there was a big payroll in the express safe. So, I hopped the same train.
Whoa.
The James Younger gang was decimated after that little fiasco they had in Northfield, Minnesota. So Jesse needed more men and took on the killer I was after, along with a host of others. I was hoping to find my man and put a bullet in his head. Climbing around that train, I must have swallowed 100 damn bugs before I reached that.
James Younger gang pulled the first train robbery west of the Mississippi.
Sounds like you hold them in high regard.
Everyone knows they were the most famous outlaw gang ever.
And you took them all off by your lonesome. Again.
Yep.
I'm finding this all a little hard to swallow, friend.
Well, maybe you need to wash it down with some whiskey. By the way, did I mention that that train was flying down those tracks like a bat out of hell?
You ready for a belly full of hot shot?
Well, I'm always ready. Something at least.
Anyway, excuse me, Ben. Where would I find the gentleman's facilities? Suddenly I have an urgent need to drain my one-eyed snake. Well, I've had more than a few drinks, and I've been sitting here for quite a spell.
Right through there. Let me show you. I never heard so much malarkey in my life.
You think he's
that
bullshit?
That same wagon all the time?
You don't think he's Silas Greaves?
I think he's just some old drunk looking for some free liquor.
Yeah.
I don't know, Jack. I think I believe
him. Same wagon once more.
You don't think he met Jesse James?
Boy, you gotta be kidding me. That story makes no sense at all.
Jack.
I mean, you gotta be two bricks short of a load to believe that cock and bull story.
I don't agree.
Jack, lay off the bull.
You seriously think that tired old man went toe-to-toe with Jesse James?
Same wagon again.
Well, that's better.
Coming back.
Did I mention that this Jim was married to the infamous Belle Star? Of course, I didn't learn that until later. Anyway, I made my way forward the best I could. Around the sides, over the roof. At some point, some sumbitch saw me and shouted out, "It's a damn Pinkerton!
It's a damn Pinkerton!"
worked for that limey cocksucker. But I guess they assumed I was one of his assassins. Those evil bastards firebombed Jesse's mother's house and killed his stepbrother.
I never worked for no Pinkertons.
Scared? Oh yeah, he's scared. Scared of what?
You don't want to mess with us!
Of course I want to mess with you.
So it's no wonder each and every asshole on that train wanted me dead.
Well, everybody's always mistaking you for somebody else, aren't they? Why is that, I wonder?
Don't let you know, Jack. I'm just telling you how I remember.
I bet you are.
You bastard!
Nope.
Yeah, you know you can't.
What the?
It was a rickety ride and quite precarious.
What the?
Ready then? I did not do that.
Well. That's how we do it.
I'll kill you!
I'll kill you, mother humper!
I came across a flat car piled high with logs and had to come up with a creative way to make my way forward. I wondered if I was ever gonna find the front of that train. Or the bastard I was after. Right about then, I was attacked by some asshole on a Gatling gun.
Yeah, seems like you run into a lot of them.
A Gatling gun again? What the man? Well, I gotta try and get past that.
Right about then, I was attacked by some asshole on a Gatling gun.
Yeah, seems like you run into a lot of them.
Asshole?
Gatling guns.
Yes, I did. Now, I don't remember how I took it out. It was either a bullet or dynamite.
Where would you find dynamite?
Well, does it really matter, Jack? You're messing with the flow of the story here. I was looking for Jim and shooting any son of a bitch stupid enough to get in my way. Yep. And that included Jesse James himself.
Mm-hmm.
Sure were a lot of men determined to die that day.
That's right.
Headshot.
It was then that Jesse detached the express car from the rest of the damn train. I could see Jesse waiting for me, fixing to kill me so he could get away with all that money.
You had a showdown with Jesse James?
Of course he didn't. Everybody knows that Jesse was killed by Bob Ford.
Yeah, Jesse went out like John Wesley Harden. Coward shot him in the back of the head.
Guess it doesn't matter how far you run, does it, Ben? Your past always catches up with you. Yeah, I didn't kill Jesse James. Just wounded him bad enough to convince him to hang up his guns.
What about that Jim fella? What happened to him?
I figure he was up front with a gun to the engineer's head.
Yep.
That bastard slipped away again. I'll tell you how I got him. But first, I need to wet my whistle.
I need to wet my whistle. Without forgiveness. Well, I think that's going to be the end of this video. I'll just give you the story here for the next time, and I'm going to continue with that, don't worry.
After my showdown with Jesse, I continued to track his brother, Frank, and that son of a bitch, Jim. I followed those bastards into the high mountains as they were going to ground.
What mountains would that be?
Somewhere in the Ozarks, I believe. A perfect place to hide out from the authorities.
Yeah. Anyway, thank you for watching. Hope to see you again. And yeah, if you have subscribed, I'm very grateful for it. It really means a lot to me. So, you know, thank you. Thank you. Anyway, as I said, hope to see you again. And, you know, I'm going to continue the story. And I'm also going to continue trying to get a virtual reality machine. But for now, I think there's not that many games for it. So, you know, it would be better probably just to wait around a month or two at least before I buy it. And I heard there's some shipping thing with them not having made that many as to how many people that are wanting to buy them. So, yeah. Anyway, thank you again. Bye.